statement is for entertainment purposes only. It is of no known scientific value. We ask that you completely ignore this useless gibberish.
Hello?
Hello, it's about the car, mate.
Yeah.
The fella behind the counter told me to give you the ring about the car, a bunch of car.
Which one is it?
Is yours a make?
It's the Mercedes you pumped, yeah?
It's the Mercedes in the car park, yeah, in St. John's. I've just had to come down into the centre to use the phone.
So what's wrong with it now? Is it scratched as well, what?
Well, it's like the door's just dented down the side and the window's shattered as well, but we made standing by it so nobody gets anything out of it.
Can you go upstairs, mate, so I can see you?
Well, not really, mate, no.
What do you mean, not really, mate? Go in the car park and I want to see you.
Well,
right?
No, don't get mad, mate.
I'm not getting mad, I'm just going to the car park and I'm coming up in a minute.
No, mate, you sound as though you're getting all mad there.
I'm not.
They may fix his cars and that,
No. I want to see you in the car park, mate. I'm not going to go mad. No. Just go in the car park. I want to see you.
So my car's all dented as well, you know.
What do you mean your car's all dented? You just f***ing bumped me. Car, for God's sake, go in the car park before I go up to your car. I'm f***ing right. Blow the thing up, right?
I
want you in the car park in 10 minutes, right, so your car is on fire.
No, your car was sticking out, you know.
My car was sticking out, the car park's got lines, mate, so my car's right in the middle of the line.
Hey, mine's all dense as well, you know, so...
Listen, mate, you bumped my car, I didn't bump yours, right? You go in the car park in 10 minutes or you won't find the car when you get back, right?
No, listen, mate.
Do you understand that?
No, hang on.
I'll bring the police, right, and I'll stay there till you come back.
Listen,
right?
Mate. No,
I'll
mate,
get
no,
the
no,
police.
No.
If you're not in the... Listen to me. If you're not in the car park in 10 minutes, I'm getting the police and I'm coming to your house. I'll blow your... Now, so never mind if not going to the car park. You're there in 10 minutes.
I could just drive off and you'd never know.
And you can just drive off?
But, you know, I've been there for three years.
Do you know, you didn't own my car in there, you know? Go in the car park in 10 minutes or you will not come back to a car. Do you understand that?
You sound as though you're going to kick me head in.
I'm not going to kick your head in. I just want to sort it out.
Look, mate, look, hang on a minute. Just listen to me. Look, I'm not insured.
Oh, God.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Well, I hope you got money in the bag, mate. Do you know how much it costs to fix that car?
Do you know
how long I've had that car in that condition, eh? Hey!
Well, hang on a minute, mate. Look, I was just looking at it because it's like a
look. Listen, mate, you're getting me angry now, right? You're not in the car park in 10 minutes. You are not going to come back to a car, and I'm going to find out who you are if you're not in the car park in 10 minutes, right?
Look, I'll leave.
Because if you haven't got insurance, you must have a lockpick or something, right? Go in the car park in 10 minutes and I'll see you there, right? We'll sort it out with the manager of the car park.
I've only been driving for about 3 weeks and
listen, mate, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to pay for your damages that you've done to my car?
Well, does your insurance cover mine as well?
My insurance cover yours? You bought me? What are you talking about, mate? Just go in the car park and we'll sort it out. Get in the car park and we'll sort it out now,
hey,
right?
Don't start shouting at me, mate.
Don't shout at you.
Don't shout at me.
Well, get in the car park and we'll see who shouts at him.
Look, I've got some money in the bank, but can I pay you, like, some, you know, £25 a week or something?
£25? No, mate, no. Forget it.
No, well, I'm going to listen. My mate does cars, and he'll fix it for you.
No, mate touches the dent my out. Car, mate, right? Mate touches my car. My car's going to go in and get done by a Mercedes dealer. I've always done it by a Mercedes dealer. It's going to get done by a Mercedes dealer. Have you been to my car, and the door has smashed the window? You must have given it a good whack.
Well, I was looking at it, because it's such a nice car, you know, and I went to my mate. Hey, isn't that car lovely?
Yeah, such a nice car. Well, look at it now. Go back and look at it now.
Are you sure it's yours?
The Mercedes, the gold one.
820 something or other.
Yeah, 820 though.
Me mate gets loads of parts from the scrappy and that, and he'll be able to, like, sort it out for you, no problem.
Mate, I don't want no parts from the scrappy. What are you talking about?
He won't even charge you.
Mate, what are you talking about? A Mercedes now? What a Fiesta?
Well, he built mine.
What have you got?
A Chevette.
A Chevette? This is a Mercedes for think this is a £50,000 car. Do you understand what you're talking? Listen, mate, stop getting me angry. Just go in the car park in 10 minutes, or I'm calling the police and I'm waiting for you till you come back. And if you don't come back, mate, you're in big trouble. Do you understand that?
I'll give you my name.
In the car park for 10 minutes.
I'll give you my name, hang on.
No, in the car. What's your name?
Tony Snell.
Who?
Tony Snell.
Ha 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 ha!
Snelly from the breakfast show at City. You've been phone scammed, Andy.
Who's responsible? Oh, who's responsible?
You're a bad narc, you.
I'm a bad narc over my car, I am, mate. Over my car,
I
am.
I wouldn't like to bump your car.
Oh, you wouldn't? I tell you what, I don't care what you've done to me, but just as long as my heart's back in its place, now I'm all right.
Hey, I'm shaking here.
You're shaking?
I'm shaking.
You want to see me?
Oh, you've just been phone scammed.
Scam day, scam day.
Picture on this telly, you know. Connected up the cable myself with a screwdriver.
No, don't scam me with that call. Scam day, scam day. Scam day, scam day.
I can't get this. I know I've tried. I can't get this. Look, that's me, BBC One. That's BBC Two. Channel 4. Look, what am I going to do for Brookside?
I'm trying to help you.
Hello? I can't get a picture, love. Look, that's me, BBC One.
What's the address?
BBC Two. ITV.
What's the address?
So I've got music on the other one. See, that's number 5. It's just music.
Have you actually signed up for cable television yourself?
How do you mean?
When you took over the address.
Oh, no, we've just connected it.
You connected it yourself?
Yeah, we had it going. It was all right, but I was just... See if someone could come out and have a look, because the BBC One's gone. I'm in Channel 4. But on number 5, it's, you know, it's just getting this, like, music and that, you know.
A technician out for your television then.
Well, you don't know where these two wires go to, yeah?
No, I don't.
This is your fault, this.
Mine?
Cable.
How can it be cable's fault? You're not even supposed to be getting cable. You haven't even signed up for it.
Well, it was all right before I connected it, wasn't it?
You shouldn't actually have connected it. What you're doing's illegal.
Well, my mate said it would be okay.
Well, your mate's wrong. What he's doing is, it's illegal.
The blue one and a yellow one.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The wire, a blue wire and a yellow wire.
Yes, but you're supposed to pay for that.
No, well, we've taken the cable in from the street.
Just hold on.
Under the carpet in the hall.
Just hold on a moment.
Through the lounge.
Just hold on, please.
Okay. Number 5's all right, look. It's a bit crackly, but it's okay, you know.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, cable TV, cable phone.
No, the telly. Look. That's me, BBC One. That's me, ITV.
Yeah, what's the address?
That's me, Channel 4.
What is the address?
And on number 5, I've just got music. That's no good to me.
What is the address?
What?
What's your address?
Number 19. Luo Zirex, Liverpool 4.
Yeah, because you haven't got cable TV.
I have got cable TV.
What's your account number?
Well, what do you mean?
Do you have cable TV?
Yeah, I was watching it last night.
Right. Do you pay for it?
Well, I pay £80, £90 a year.
£80, £90 a year. Have you got an account?
Let me get my license out the drawer.
Joanne.
Hello?
Hello?
I've got a television license.
No, not your television license.
But that's all I've got.
Yeah, well, you're not a cable TV subscriber.
I was watching it last night.
Yeah, you might have been watching it, but you're not subscribed. You're not paying us any money.
I don't know, you have to pay for it.
You do have to pay for it.
Well, it's gone off anyway. Look, that's BBC.
Yeah, it's gone off because you're not paying for it.
That's...
We don't give you cable TV for nothing.
Well, where's my BBC One gone then?
You'll have to get it retuned.
I'm just getting music on that one.
You are not an active cable TV subscriber. You have never been a cable TV subscriber.
Well, it was going smashing last night.
Yeah, you're breaking the law doing that.
But two of the wires have come out.
Right.
But what's this music on here? On 5.
off on...
I'm not prepared to advise you what to do because you're breaking the law.
Well, how do I get MTV?
You won't be able to. You don't subscribe to Cable Northwest.
But I had it last night.
Yeah, by other means that are outside our control. I'm not giving you... We're not giving you channels.
Hang on, there's a wire come out the back here. Hang on. Oh! Oh, well, that's great, that is, isn't it? Ow! Oh, well, that's fantastic, that now!
Why, what's happened?
The screen's gone in!
Yeah, well, that's because you're using means that are not Cable Northwest qualified. We're not giving you channels.
Oh, hey, whoa! Unplug it, unplug it! What time can you come round and fix it?
We're not coming round to fix it. You will have to call an aerial engineer.
I haven't
got... You don't subscribe to Cable Northwest. You don't subscribe to Sky. You are getting TV pictures via somebody else's cable pictures.
Well, my mate
and
just...
that is breaking the law.
Well, my mate just showed me how to wire it up, and it was a great picture. It was...
Yeah, but you are breaking the law. You're not paying us
and
any
footy
money.
And footy was on. But look, me footy was on, and I watched MTV, and I watched Star Trek, the
yeah,
new
but you
generation.
Don't pay for it.
I tell you
you're
what...
You're stealing somebody's pictures.
I had the radio on it as well.
Yeah, you might be able to, but you're not getting it from Cable Northwest.
I had that City FM on it coming through. Have you heard of that City FM?
Yeah, but you... That's nothing to do with us.
Well, you're on that station right now and you've been telephone scammed. Hello?
Well, great. Can I have a copy?
Can you have a copy?
Yeah, please.
Did you like the exploding telly?
I loved it.
Did you?
I loved it.
Did you like that one?
I thought it was great.
Ooh, you've just been phone scammed.
Thank you, Cable North.
It is for entertainment purposes only. It is of no known scientific value. We ask that you completely ignore this useless gibberish.
There's me lorry here. It's full of sand and soil here. Let me come and fill his pond in, eh? Here we are. Is this Larkham Way?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's the number for the delivery, mate? Hello?
What's the number for what?
We've got a number, but we haven't got an house number.
This is number two.
Number two. Right. We should be there in about 20 minutes.
Who should?
City engineers, mate.
City engineers? What for?
We got this sand and soil in the wagon for you. Have you ordered it?
Well, hang on, but what are you going to do with this sand and stone?
No, it's sand and soil. We just got a job sheet, mate, just saying it's, you know, to be delivered. Hang on a second, mate, let's get the job sheet, hang on. Hello?
Hello.
Sand and soil mix. 4.5 ton.
To be delivered.
4.5 ton.
Well, I don't know what your job sheet is.
It's number two, is it?
Number two, yeah.
Yeah, it's something about a hole in the back or something. You just wanted to cover it over.
The hole in the back? When you say in the back,
well, on
what
the job,
do you mean the back?
Do you want
about my back garden?
Yeah, do you want it in the back or at the front?
I don't want it anyway.
Well, we just got a job sheet saying it's got to be delivered this morning.
Well, you can go and dump it in the street, but it's not getting put in my back.
Well, we just got a job sheet here just saying it's something to do to fill this hole in the back.
Well, I haven't got a hole in the back.
I've
got a hole. Well, yeah, I've got a hole in my back garden.
Hang on a second, mate. Hang on a sec. I know what it is, mate. Yeah, I know what it is. It's a pond or something. It's an old pond that's being taken out.
Yeah, old pond being taken out. It's only been here a couple of years. I've done it myself.
It's a planning permission job.
Planning permission to dig a hole.
Have you got no planning permission, mate? But that's what it'll be.
Planning, I haven't built anything. What's the one planning permission for?
Remove pond, fill in hole. That's what's all on the job sheet, mate. Remove pond, fill in hole. You say you got a pond in the back, you shouldn't have it.
Oh, behave, who says this, like?
We just got a job sheet from our boss, Jennings.
Well, take it back to your boss and tell him to get in touch with me,
mate,
because there's nobody coming here to fill in my pond.
You're joking, aren't you, matey? I mean, we want to get this done by 12 o'clock. We knock off.
You won't be getting it done by 12 o'clock. You won't be getting it done by 12 o'clock next week, never mind today.
Well, would you want to... I'll give him his number if you want to give him a ring, mate. Because, you know, it's a bit of a snotty get, like...
Because
we've got to go to Egbeth, you know what I mean? We've got to go to Egbeth. We wanted to get to you first. You're in Kirkdale, aren't you?
Yeah.
We want to get to you first.
Hang on a minute. Come on, give us the number.
471.
471.
Hello?
Come on.
0318.
0318. And who's this? Jennings?
John Jennings, yeah.
Right, so I'll phone this fella up and tell him to go and stuff his sand and stone.
Well, I don't know, mate. You know, we're just dropping it off and filling it in. That's all we've been told to do. And we don't know anything about, like, what's there, what isn't there, you know.
All right, mate.
All right, cheers.
Ta-da, mate.
He's going to John Jennings, John Jennings' secretary.
Okay, I'll try again.
Have a go. Have a go, yeah.
Hello, John Jennings, secretary. Can I help you?
Yeah, could I speak to John, please?
One moment, please.
Hello, John Jennings.
Hello, Mr. Jennings. I'm sorry.
Yes.
This is a Mr. Sumner here. I've just had a phone call.
Sorry, who?
Mr. Sumner. I've just had a phone call. I think it was off a portable phone. Men come around here saying they've got sand and stone on. And they've got to come around here and fill my pond in at the back. It's a worksheet. They said they're from the engineers department.
Right. What's your address, please?
Number 2, Clarkin Way.
It's to do with a pond that you have in the back.
I'm not having this. It's only a hole in the ground. Why shouldn't you plan a permission to dig a hole? There's a pond there, and there's a pond staying there, because anybody comes round here with sand and stone, you better send quite a few, because nobody's getting in my back garden.
Well, look, we don't want any scenes at all.
We don't want any scenes. Then take your sand and stone somewhere else and stop acting the arsehole.
It's a hazard. It's a hazard to anybody who may wander into the garden, or children, maybe relatives, and they...
Look, if anybody wandered into my back garden, it would be a hazard, because I'd kick the shit out of them. They're not supposed to be there.
Well, look, I'm sure there's no need for this kind of language.
But there's no need for you phoning me up telling me you're going to get shut in me pond.
Well, you can't have a pond, and I'm afraid that's going to be the top and tail of it.
But I tell you now, you're wasting your time, because I don't care who you send around, the pond's not going. And if they come in, as I said, it's 2'6", so it's deep enough for me to get them in.
No, I'm sorry, you can't have a pond in the back garden, and we will be there within the hour to fill the pond in.
Then we're going to stick the fish.
Will you... Oh, you have fish as well?
Of course I've got fish.
Oh, I thought it was just for show.
I've got koi carp in this.
Well, can't you take them out and put them in plastic bags for now?
I said koi carp, not goldfish. I'm not letting them do it. I'd put my heart into this.
Well, I'm sorry. I, as a keen gardener myself, I understand how you must feel, but...
And what have you got in your back garden?
Well, I don't have a pond. Tacky things.
What do you mean, tacky?
Well, I wouldn't dream of having a pond in the back garden.
No, obviously not. Your attitude, your missus will probably shove you in it.
Well, I don't think there's any kind of need for that attitude.
I'm the one that's getting the pond filled in, and I'm the one that's wasted my time for the last 3 years.
Well, you're...
shelled out between £350 and £500.
Well, more fool you.
What do you mean, more fool me? I'm enhancing my back garden, you know what I mean? And it's all part of the community as well, with the trees that I've planted, and all the plants, you know what I mean? The green environment, like.
Do you let any members of the community in to enjoy this pond? No, you don't.
Yes, because my wife used to work in a nursing home, and she'd bring the old folks down to sit around the pond sometimes.
No, I think you're just clutching at straws now to try and convince me to let you keep it.
It's not like I've got a garage out there, like, and I'm fixing cars or something, and I've got drills going and all that stuff.
Well, you can't have it, I'm afraid. We're going to come and take it away. You can keep the pond. If you don't want the pond, if you don't want the actual thing that sinks into the ground, we'll gladly take that off your hands and dispose of it.
It's a big black polythene liner. And you know the two that come round? If they take it out, I'll wrap them up in it and I'll post them back to you.
Well, that's nice.
This is the most stupid thing I've ever heard of. We get all these weird birds down in our backyard now that I've never seen before. We've got little finches, bleaches and all kinds here. We've seen them anywhere else. They only come
and
down because of the pond.
And you imagine they just come because of the pond?
That's right, because these...
No, I think you're living in a dream world. No, I think you're living in a dream world, to be honest.
There's no dream world here. What I have here is reality.
No, well, you're telling me that you have blue finches and blue tits and all kinds of exotic birds that come just to visit your pond. Who are you trying to deceive?
I'm not trying to deceive anyone.
Well, what is the access like to the back of the property?
I guess your fellows will find out when they get here.
Look, you're not making this any easier for yourself.
I don't intend to make it any easier.
Look, the jails are full of people like you.
Well, then an extra one won't matter, will it? And then when I'm gone, you can get shut at a pond. But mind you, it's all right. My wife will take you on then.
Yes, I know your wife.
What do you mean you know me wife?
I know... Sharon.
What?
Yes, I know Sharon, your wife.
What do you mean you know Sharon? This fella says he knows you.
Yes, I've had long chats in the afternoon with Sharon.
What's going on? What's going on? You're sort of saying he's having long chats with you in the afternoon?
No, someone phoned up about the pond and I told them to ring back when you were in.
Who the bleeding hell are you? What are you on about? You're having long... What's going on?
Nothing, I don't know. They just phoned up about the pond.
No.
I didn't want to upset you.
I don't believe this.
Ah, right. Well, I've obviously caught you at a bad time.
A bad time? The worst hasn't happened yet.
Can I give you a name and a number for more information?
Yes, please.
If you ask for a Mr. Snell...
Mr. Snell?
Yes.
Snell? You're kidding me.
Hi,
Ricky. Not you, is it, Snell?
Hi, Ricky.
Oh, for Christ's sake. Oh, you... you swine. Oh, Jesus Christ, Snell. Thank you very much. I'm going out to get pickaxe handles and everything up my shed here.
You've just been phone scammed.
It is for entertainment purposes only. It is of no known scientific value. We ask that you completely ignore this useless gibberish.
Hello?
Hello, RSPB here, Ainsdale. Can I speak to, is it a Mr. Heron? About the pigeons, please.
Oh, he's not in, is it where?
Oh, maybe you could help me, love.
Well, I haven't got time, really, because I'm just going out to get a bus.
Oh, are you?
And yeah. If I don't get it, it's not one for another hour, you see.
Very important, this, you know.
I know, but I haven't got time. I'll miss the bus otherwise.
Oh, can we come and take the pigeons, then, about, 1 o'clock?
Sorry, no.
Not at all?
No.
They've got to be inoculated, you know.
Oh.
They've got to be inoculated.
Listen, you'll have to speak to him about it.
Is there anyone there I can speak to while you go for the bus?
No.
Just I only need some information.
I know, but...
I'm going to miss the bus.
I'll have to go. I'm going to miss this bus, and if I don't get it... You know, I've got to wait for another hour, and I won't be able to go.
All right, love.
Okay.
Okay, then.
Bye.
Ta-ra now. Later that morning...
Hello.
Hello, love. I called earlier on today about the pigeons. You asked me
to call... Hang on, he's in.
Okay, love.
Okay.
Hello.
I called earlier on today. I was trying to get you.
Yeah.
But, obviously, you know, you've been out.
I've been where? I've just got in now.
Okay, mate. All pigeon fanciers through the Liverpool area.
Yeah.
With the new EEC rules, I've got to be checked through now, you know.
Yeah.
And each one of them have got to be inoculated.
Yeah.
So we're just wondering when we can come and get them, you know.
How do you mean, come and get them?
Well, we'll have to take them and inoculate them, you see.
Oh, well, you won't do mine. You're out of order.
No,
you've never seen it. You're either taking the piss or you're out of order.
No, it's different regulations now, you see. This came in.
Get down here now.
Hey?
Get down here now.
Can we take them now?
No, you're not taking them now. You can come down.
How many have you got, mate?
I've got 50.
50?
Yeah.
Hang on, let's just...
And 25 youngsters.
The new EC rules, the classed as vermin, so they need to be inoculated in Ainsdale.
No, you bring me proof down. No one comes in here without bringing me proof down. Proof, everything like that, lad.
Well, we can bring that down for you.
Well,
we can bring that down for you.
That's all right. I'll get someone in here. Bring it down, I'll get someone down here.
When's the best time?
Right now.
Right now?
Right now.
Well, I'm knocking off now, mate. Can we not come in the morning?
Yeah.
Can we not come in the morning?
No.
What about over the weekend? Is anyone in over the weekend?
No.
Is there anyone in over the weekend?
Yes, I'm here at the weekend.
Oh, what's the best time to come and get them then?
You're not taking them.
Oh, come on, mate. You know, you're only hindering things here.
Well.
You're only hindering things here.
No chance.
We'll inoculate them.
Yeah.
At £1.50 a bird.
Yeah.
And we'll lose the VAT if you can pay it cash.
But you're taking a piss.
But
you wouldn't be able to do that to anyone racing at this time of the year.
Test.
That's all the shit.
Well, there's no need to take this kind of attitude, you know.
Don't call again on the phone.
Hey?
As soon as speak to you face-to-face, don't call again on the phone.
Well, we're knocking off now, you see. I don't want to be sending...
I don't give a damn where you're at.
I don't want to be calling
again on the phone.
I don't want to be sending...
Otherwise, I'll get the police and you say your number.
Well, I don't want to be sending fellas out in vans at this time of the...
I don't give a damn.
This is your last chance.
Hello, lad.
Hey, hang on. Whoa.
You've just been phone scammed.
So, stop the pigeon. 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 Stop the pigeon.
If anybody knows him, can you tell him it was me? Because I couldn't get back in touch with him.
Stop that pigeon now.
please, please, just tell him it was me. Don't tell him where I am, but just tell him it was me. It's exactly 8:20 to the newsroom.
Now you see to stick the probe in there.
Well, if you take him out, you can put him back in. There's no problem with that, is there?
Right. I don't know why you're being so obtrusive here and being so kind of negative about it.
Well, I'm not. I mean, you can understand my point of view. Do you know what I mean? If you, I mean, it's going to take you, what, X amount of months, weeks, or whatever.
No, it's only going to take about 10 days. I don't see what.
No, it's
going to
take you X amount of weeks or months.
No, it'll take 10 days.
To take me through court. That's what I'm saying to you.
Oh, no, no, not where bats are concerned, mate. No, not at all. They're an endangered species.
All right, well,
we could have our people down there, and we could have you, if we wanted to, we could have you out by 5 o'clock tonight. No messing. No, and we've done it before, and we wouldn't hesitate to do it to you. I know you think it's funny.
I don't think it's funny. I don't think it's funny if I'm going to get safed out of my property by 5 o'clock tonight.
Well, listen, we can get there. What are you doing now? What?
Not a great deal. Well, that's what I'm saying to you.
Can we meet you there?
Come on down.
What time?
See you in an hour.
All right, there'll be a guy. I'm not coming. There'll be a guy who'll come down.
What's his name?
Mr. Wayne.
Mr. what?
Mr. Wayne.
Wayne.
Yeah, Bruce Wayne.
Bruce Wayne.
Right. He'll have an assistant with him.
Called?
Robin.
Robin.
Right.
See you in an hour, whoever. Right.
Get the boys going.
To the Batmobile. Let's go. Atomic batteries to power. Turbines to speed.
Roger. Ready to move out.
They're on the way. They're on the way, Kev. They're coming down to Garston now. Watch out. He didn't click. Let him stew for a while.
Ooh, you've just been phone scammed!